Welcome everyone to the first hosted performance of the Youth Chorus of Kansas City's 2022-2023 season, A Dark and Stormy Night. We are so glad that you are here. My name is Ryan Main. I'm the Artistic and Executive Director of the Youth Chorus of Kansas City, and we cannot wait to share this performance with you. So I want to share a few bits of information before we begin, because unlike many of our other performances, this is going to be a single through performance. Our students will be filling in some of the transitions between our pieces. Our students have taken on a lot of extra responsibility and a lot of difficult music to make this concert happen. So please, after today's performance, please share with them moments that you thought were where they absolutely shone, and please give them a high five. They have absolutely earned it. We have been thinking about doing this concert, A Dark and Stormy Night, for several years. And so once we finally found a space like this, we knew that this was the time to go for it. We'd like to thank the folks at the Medallion Theater, specifically the folks who operated Plexpod Westport. Can we get a round of applause for them? They've gone absolutely above and beyond to make sure that this has been an excellent experience for us and for your students, and we are truly grateful to them. Inside of your programs, you'll notice that there is an envelope, and inside that envelope, there's some information about giving to the Youth Chorus of Kansas City. Donations, individual donations, are about one-third of our entire annual revenue, and it's part of why we are able to do the things that we are able to do. So we hope that you will feel moved today by by these students' just absolutely wonderful performances, and we hope that you will be generous in your support of these young people. We would ask at this time that you please take a moment to silence your devices. If you have a phone, please double check that it won't ring during our performance. We will be professionally recording our performances this year, and so please don't feel the need to record those. We will be sharing our performance recording with you. If you have a young child in the audience and they feel moved to sing along with the performance, they can do so from the hallway out back. Please help us maintain a nice, quiet environment. This is an aural, a auditory art, and we want to be able to maintain that space for these students to do their art. Finally, there's one change. Zoe Horton will be performing the solo for Prelude in place of Brandon, and the song is Something in the Dark. Friends, thank you so much for being here today. So many adults have worked tirelessly to make this happen. And again, because we're not going to really talk again before the end of the concert, I'd like to take a moment to recognize our parent council. Parent council, would you please wave or stand up and be recognized? In addition, our partners in education are the music teachers of our wonderful Youth Chorus students all throughout the metro area, and you'll see them in our program. If you see your student's teacher here today, please thank them for the work that they do to help make this opportunity possible for your singer. Finally, from me to our staff, I would like to say thank you. We have taken on a lot this year, and our staff has risen to every challenge that we have thrown their way. I'm grateful for each and every one of you. Thank you. Please enjoy A Dark and Stormy Night.
Ha ha! creatures were creeping, and the wind was whistling down the hill. Looking around, I began to spy ghosts, goblins, and other spooky beasts. Though you may be frightened, we'll have to ask you not to scream. Leave that to us. Listen, if you dare.
Thank you. In Mexico, a holiday called Día de los Muertos celebrates the loved ones and ancestors who have gone on before us. The ofrenda, or altar, is celebrated, is laid out in their memory with favorite foods, drinks, and photos of happy memories. Join us as we remember our abuelito, Don Jose.
Entre flores.
I was standing watch all alone that night, and I heard a wailing cry that sent a shiver down my spine as a cold wind blew. This is the story of the ghost ship, and the story is true, I promise you, and it's sure to happen again.
The stars are set, 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 Make believe. was a dark and stormy night, and the world was fast asleep. Some dreamt of joy and gold, and others dreamt of something darker. The day of wrath. A waking nightmare descends upon the earth, and a cloud of smoke leaves a world of fire and ashes and smoke. I know, we got really dark there. But we promise you that rescue is coming. From all along the midnight skies, as though it were a wandering cloud, the ghostly dream ship will soon fly.
Thank you. hour, I have not been as others were. I have not seen as others saw. These are the words of a master of creepy poetry, Edgar Allan Poe. He describes a tragic life story that soon takes a sinister turn.
Day of the month of September, in an early year of a decade, not too long before our own, the the sky.